Hello, Lollypoppers, and yes, pre-drawn canvas here. I'm Lollypop01ML here today, and welcome to another episode of Lollypop Speed Art. And monthly challenge number 5, I decided to do flower in bloom with this. Oh, and you're gonna get some magic here today, because I actually did finish this piece at my sister's, so just wait for it. So, flower in bloom, which is May's monthly challenge that I set for myself, and I decided to go with 4 specific flowers here. And of course, being that it's the month of May, and of course, April showers bring May flowers. So the first flower I decided to do here was the lily. Now the lily, I actually have some like history with this. Well, not personally. Lilies are one of my favorite flowers, and at my house, we actually used to have a little pitted little area that had some lilies that were red and yellow. And I actually recently got some lilies from bulb plants from Walmart. And they usually grow every summer. But of course, you have to be careful with lily flowers, because the flowers themselves, all the parts of the flower and the leaves itself are very toxic to animals, especially dogs and cats. But anyways, with the lily flower, what you're seeing here, I decided to try doing a mauvey pink for the lily here, and in the final piece it actually looks a little bit more brown, but don't worry, it's still alive. It's a painting. I did this with acrylics. And the other thing is that the lily flower is also synonymous with one of my original characters, Liliana Scarlett Monroe, as her nickname is Lily, and Liliana just means lily flower in Spanish. Next up is the hibiscus flower, and truth be told, we do have hibiscus type flowers here in New York, although they only come up during the late summer. They're called the Rose of Sharon. But I went with a tropical hibiscus, the same thing that I went with my acrylic painting of Moana, even though, yeah, I did not do a speed art episode of it. I actually gave the painting to my niece for her first birthday. So I went with, what I was going for was like an orangey, yellow, red hibiscus flower. And oh, I forgot to mention that the references, I just pulled them off from Pinterest to help me, especially with the carnation, which you will see in a bit. Now, hibiscus are very tropical, like you would find them generally in warmer climates and whatnot. And of course, yes, the lighting makes it seem like it's more orange than what it is. It's more yellow orange, leaning red orange. That's what I went with. And of course, like, I'm blending out the petals here, making them look nice and whatnot with my paintbrush, my little paintbrush here, Winsor & Newton, the same brush that I had since college. I did not take painting in college. Like, we did a little bit of watercolor and drawing too, but in color class, but I'm not really that. I really did not choose painting as my studio sequence. I chose figure drawing and digital photography. But I do love flowers though. They're beautiful and they're bright, and I love seeing them in spring. Usually here we get daffodils, and of course the Rose of Sharon, the cherry blossoms, at least with my tree, obviously. And of course, next I'm going in and adding the stem. Next is a flower that I found out was also a bulb flower that comes up every year. This is called the dahlia, and I decided to go with a purple dahlia here. They have like multiple petals, and the center is all nice. Next is my personal favorite, the carnation. I'm not 100% sure if they are bulb plants, but I don't think they come up every single year. I think they're perennials. But carnations are synonymous with prom and whatnot. And I actually had a, not a pink carnation, but a white carnation as part of my corsage. And the other thing is that we also got carnation flower when I graduated from AUK. Now anyways, I'm going with the background, and I went with the color Prussian blue for the background. Yes, don't worry, I'm going to touch up on the stem and the leaves in a bit. And yes, you get to see me! Yes, and my, due to unfortunate circumstances, I am awake nightshirt. Basically, it's a nightgown, obviously. I love big shirts and pants. So here I am going in with the leaves here. Obviously, making sure they're nice and bright. Making the details here as perfect as possible. And of course, I went in with the milky white and the cabot blue or cobalt blue to make the background even brighter. So that is it. The final pieces on my BDM art page. Please subscribe to my channel and ring the bell for notifications. I post videos like this Fridays and Saturdays twice a month. And I will see you next time.